into breezy Titchwell, and I've no idea whether you can actually hear me or not at the moment with this wind. Very good. Ooh, don't normally like that hide much, but that was nice. Lynn has just taken her parents back to the house, but not before we both managed to get absolutely wonderful views of Bearded Tit. Years and years and years and years and years I've been waiting for a decent view of a Bearded Tit. I have seen them before, but fleeting glimpses, long, long, long distance shots, tiny little images in my scope. What a fantastic 10 minutes that was, and possibly photographed, no idea. I was so shaking with excitement, they're probably all blurry and motion blurred, but I don't give two monkeys. That was bloody hell. Oh, I just don't know what else to say now about it. Brilliant. I can think of no more words than brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. And Lynn was so excited as well. She was trying to get video desperately. No idea whether she did or not. And we were going to stay in the other hide and not go. Well, then the parents wanted to go home, so we were just... witnessed a marsh harrier food pass, and then about 10 minutes later got much better views of the cuckoo. So the last hour has just been phenomenal. Really, really good. And it's really odd because I've probably been in here about an hour now and sat and waited and witnessed the food pass, the cuckoo. And people keep coming in and 2 minutes leave, 2 minutes leave. Whatever happened to patience? Still, it means the hive's nice and quiet for us. We just need a bittern now. We made a silly prediction earlier of getting bearded tit bitterns and cuckoo all sat on a branch together. And obviously we've not had them sitting on a branch together, but we have had bearded tit and we have had cuckoo. So we're going to stay here now until we see a bittern. We're not really.
No.
It could be in months.